linear regression, reducing RMSE or increasing R square, will be just postponing for the other session. Same linear regression, how to do pre-processing, how to do cleaning, and how to do all the exploratory analysis and visual analysis, all those things we are continuing again with different data set. Finally, we end up with linear regression model fitting. Then we will be predicting RMSE and R square value. So the same procedure we are going to do, but here there are the feature engineering, the way we do deal with each and every variable would be different. Now, let us have a quick glance at the data. Date traveled, name of the car. Name of the car is not going to become so influential. Let us see one by one. Then seller detail, then offer type, AB test is the quality of the test something for the vehicle. Then vehicle type, then year of registration, gearbox type, manual or automatic. See, there are missing values, so many missing values. So we will see how to deal with these missing values also. Then power PS, something like a power capacity, model, kilometer, utilization, the mileage, whatever it has happened, number of utility, the number of miles they traveled. Then month of registration, fuel type, brand, etc., etc. These all the data we will be looking at. Whether undergone repair or not, brand of the vehicle, date created, postal code, these all the data we are going to look at. So now, the question is, what is a predictive variable or Y variable? Here also price, but the data is jumbled here. Instead of in the house price, it was kept it in the last, whereas here it is kept in the middle price. We supposed to be careful what we are predicting. That's why I gave here red color. And these are all, if you look at numerical data, this numerical data, the moment it comes numerical data, we supposed to go for linear regression because it is a continuous value or numerical data, so that we need to use linear regression. That much we are clear. Finally, what are all the way we are going to check normality, outlier, and working range of the data? So many other aspects we'll be discussing, missing value treatment and categorical way. See, the manual gear, automatic gear, we need to deal this data. We need to convert this categorical value to dummy variable, that is numerical. We need to encode it. So that encoding we need to do. Similarly here, petrol, diesel type. So these all we need to encode it. Then BMW, Toyota, Ford. So these all also we may need to encode. Yes, no type, we may need to encode. Whenever we see this kind of categorical, SUV, bus, small car, name of the type of the vehicle. So these are all those things we need to take care. Then test control, these all we need to convert it into dummy variable. That is what of our discussion going to become. Now let us go to the notebook. Yeah, it's a kind of necessary packages, pandas. For without pandas, we cannot even load the data, we cannot even process the data. This is our hero. We need to bring the data set to the notebook, only then we can think of doing small job or great job. Then NumPy is for all the numerical processing. Seaborn is for plotting. Here, if you notice, no Matplotlib I am using here, advanced plotter. So whatever we are going to look at is little bit of advanced than Matplotlib. So Seaborn. Again, the very biggest hero of the entire machine learning is sklearn. I said this is what more important, sklearn. Now this is very crisp than the previous notebook. Sklearn model dot model selection import train underscore test underscore split. This is for splitting the data. Already we discussed the data need to be splitted 20, either 20, 80, 20 ratio. This is for train, this is for test, or 75. The best thumb rule is 75, 25 ratio, or 70, 30, whatever, depending upon the developer's perspective, 90, 10. 90-10 data splitting. For this splitting job is carried out by train, test, and split. Next, our main objective goal of the notebook today is car, second hand car prediction. Sorry, not only car, all the vehicle prediction, even bus data is also available. People are selling bus also. So this is second hand vehicle price prediction, rather I can say. So main objective is to use linear regression. That is the beauty of Python. If you look at the word keyword itself, linear, this is called capitalized variable. This also we discussed types of variable naming convention. So linear and R is capitalized. For this, we need to use sklearn.linear_model. Importing the necessary package, the important package is linear regression. Next, what we are doing is in the same notebook, we are going for one more prediction. Temporarily, let me not explain, but I can introduce random forest regressor. Already, I discussed that what are all the predictive modeling available. One is linear, another one is MARS, another one is KNN, another one is random forest regressor. I said several times. Random forest regressor. So the same notebook is used for both of the purposes. That's why this is brought, nothing to worry. So this next is matrices. Finally, model validation. Again, I just give you a quick recap. We may need to go for model validation, whatever we do. The model validation starts with number one, splitting the data. After splitting the data, we need to fit the data or model building. After model building, validation, model validation. These are all the three predominant steps. So for this splitting the data, we are using train split, this one, this function, this one we are using. For model building, what we are using? Linear regression. For validation, what we are using? Mean squared error. Random forest regressor is one more model building. That's it. But the same train test split we can use, same mean squared error we can use. No need to worry of that. Random forest is yet another model. That's it. But any learning, now machine learning or data science, it has predominantly these three steps. Is it okay? Now again, quick recap we were looking at. Now we are importing the data or loading the data, whatever we can say. Normally we are going to call it as cars data. That's it. This is a data frame, name of the data frame. Whatever the name you like, any god, goddess name or your own name or anyone you can keep on using this. It's a data frame name like a variable name. That's it. Now what we are doing using pd.read_csv function, we are reading that required file or necessary file. The name of the file what we are using is cars_sampled.csv. The path is this, then we are loading it. That's it. Tomorrow I'll be sharing both data set and the same notebook. No need to worry. Then we are taking a copy of it. Why we are taking a copy of it? Original data frame, we don't want to disturb. We want to work, we want to do exploratory analysis. We want to infer, or we may need to know a lot, many insights of the data with the data frame. So for that, we are just taking a copy of it. This also we discussed. Next, very predominant. We need to understand the data. Like a kind of hello, Arvind, somewhere it's clumsy, Arvind. Saran, sorry, Saran, somewhere it's clumsy. I don't know whom side that noise is coming out. Yeah, thank you. Cars.info, this is what? Now only we are trying to understand the data. It's like the moment we become friend of anyone, the moment we start making friendship with a stranger, we will be trying to know their information as much as possible. What is their name? What is their family background? Which native like that? So info is a function helps us to know more information about the data set. So this info already we discussed. It will list out each and every column. How many records available? If you look at the highest records available in the data set, says 50,001 record. 50,000 records we have in this Excel sheet. 50,000 rows are available, sales data. Then not null, object, int 64, these all we know, data type, what type of data it is available. Totally, it has only two data type. Categorical data of 13 variable, numerical data is of 6 variable. That's it. Now we are going for formatting. It's all optional. If you wish, you can use or else not a condition. PD, it is also part of pandas package. Dot set underscore option, display dot float format. What we are trying to do is, while displaying, we are restricting to using lambda function. We are restricting each and every variable x. After the decimal point, only 3 digits we are permitting. Look at now, it has dot 00, dot 00, something like that. If you wish, if you put 0.2 or 0.1 after the decimal point, how many digit you wish, you can change it. Lambda is one of the useful function. It will automatically work on each and every variable. That is the beauty of this lambda function. So the function which we use is set option for the display float format. This is all we need to use as such. Then only here we have the freedom to change the value. Then after setting this, no need to do anything with our data. It's a kind of preference. I'm telling that I want only North Indian meals. I'm giving preference. Then whatever you offer, if it is of North Indian meal, I will be eating. That's it. So similarly, we are just giving a condition or preference. Here only, after giving preference, we are using our own data. Cars.describe. The moment it, how it is describes is based on this person's or this conditions or this preferences. That's it. So nothing great we are doing. Simply we are using to control after the dot. We are controlling with 3 digits. Already we discussed describe is the function will work on only the numerical data, numerical variable. So this is our Y variable. These are all 5 variables comes under independent variable or X variable. So whatever, whether it is dependent or independent X or Y, it shows only the available numerical data. That's fine. Now next, again, we are giving one more preference. No need to worry. Set max column, comma 500. Number of columns need to be displayed. We are setting up to 500. We don't have that many columns. Of course, these are a versatility to be ready with a formatting commands of Python. This is not mandatory. Now again, we are describing the same data set with a different. So here we are displaying only 6 variable. Nothing more we have. The numerical itself 6 variable that we come to know through info function. So 6 variable, we no need to worry of that much. Now that's fine. Very first we started dealing with data. Cleaning data or pre-processing data, whatever the verbal you want to use, you can use. We are grouping them the column names, name of the car. No way it is useful in prediction. Instead of name of the car, fuel type, what model, engine model, these are all the prime data will be influential towards the prediction. So that we are trying to drop name. Date traveled, which date last it is traveled, and that is not a matter whether you use it car was used in the month of December 2019 or October 2019. It's not my botheration. The condition of car is only my botheration. What date you traveled with that car, date created, postal code, what I'm going to do with the car selling, because house means postal code would be lot of influential. If it is Bangalore, Majestic, the postal code is much more powerful than Alahanka. It is somewhere outskirts. So that postal code would be much more influential. Last seen, that and all not required. So whatever is not, actually, if we have description of the data set, we will come to know. Tomorrow while sharing the data set, I'll be giving you description of each and every parameters or variable also. While going through the description, through our common sense, we can sensitize which are all the variable highly useful in our prediction. It should speak something. What is prediction? If I say about today's temperature, humidity value, moisture level, cloud pattern, if I tell really that will be or the sweating pattern, whatever. I used to feel very sensitivity before the rain comes. Couple of hours or even 24 hours ago, I will start sweating. Extraordinary sweating will come out. Then within 24 hours, I used to enjoy with rain the blessings. Similarly, for that, what is required? That parameter which I am giving, it need to be useful. Suppose I am asking you to predict whether rain would come in my nativity or not. I am telling I ate banana, two banana today I ate. Do you think that I eating two banana will be helpful for you to predicting whether rain would come or not in my nativity? Not at all. So eating banana is no way connected with rain prediction. Rather, if I talk about moisture level, if I talk about the humidity level, if I talk about temperature, if I talk about the cloud pattern, if I talk about sweating pattern of my own sensitivity, these all would be helping you in predicting whether rain would come or not. That all based on common sense only. We need to work and we need to group them up, and we are giving in the variable or data frame column. Then we are substituting that column to columns, axis equal to drop. Already we discussed axis equal to 1 means it's going to delete a column. Axis equal to 0 means it's going to delete a row. So these are all the columns identified and grouped and kept it in column. We drop, deleted, over. Next, what we are trying to do, we are trying to remove the duplicate records. We don't know. For example, you may be trying to sell your car to me. Suma also may be trying to sell a car to me, or Girish also trying to sell a car to me. And both of you giving all your column details, what is a model type, whatever the requirement I'm asking, you will be giving me. But there is a chance of repeating your own data more than one time. If you meet my own myself, I will be entering one time. If you come and meet my own other colleague in my office, then he or she may tend to influence the data once again. We don't know. So just using this command, we can delete all the duplicate records. Duplicate means not only one column. The entire column, whatever the number of columns we have, in each column, assume, let us assume this is one record. Maybe after 1 month, you would have approached one of my colleague in my office. Then you would have given your detail that you want to sell your car once again. Then these two, typically the entire row detail will start resembling. This is called duplication. So if at all available, it is safer for deleting it, because repetition will mislead the data. Repetition will become, these kind of data will take domination. Overtraining will happen, overfitting will happen. So that we are identifying using this function. Since Python gives all the sophistication luxury facilities, we can just try it. Cars.drop_duplicates keep equal to first. What is the meaning is, retain, if at all occurrences of duplication comes, this may be the record number 10, this may be the record number 500, retain the first record 10 and delete the 500. In place equal to true means, go and reflect in the data set itself, the complete data set, that data frame itself, it's going to become true. In place is going to get affected, it's going to become true. That's it. So this just helps us in deleting all the duplication record. Whereas these kind of functions we haven't used in house data. If you wish, you can apply this also. Now we are, where we are doing through our common sense, we dropped some column. Then we thought of deleting all the duplications, because duplication will become dominant. Whichever the data is with the same phenomena of same in observation, it starts repeating, those all will start domineering. Then it will mislead our prediction. So that we deleted that. Now we are going towards missing value treatment, handling missing values. Let us look at isNull.sum. Yes. Plenty of missing value we have. Vehicle type is missing, gearbox is missing, model is missing, fuel type is missing, not repaired, damage is missing. And how we are going to treat these all? Next, first we want to understand, is there any missing value? If at all, how many? Now if you look at, we have 50,000 records. Either we can do deletion of these all records, because we have 50,000, plenty. Or we can do Imputation, any one method of imputation, or we need to look at each and every variable, what way we need to fill it, that also we need to sensitize. So we will just hold on. I'm just making you to have your food for thought, how each and every variable could be treated. Vehicle type, gearbox, model, fuel type, not repaired, damaged. So these are all the five variables troubling us. So how we are going to deal, let us see. Variable year of registration. What we are trying to do, year of registration, this one concept I haven't touched in the previous notebook. This is also highly equivalent to all other pre-processing technique which we discussed with house price. What we need to do is, it's called working range data or workable range data. Workable data range. We need to find out workable data range. What is a workable data range? For example, all the vehicles available, the data selling, most of the time I'm trying to sell cars only. All of a sudden, some 10, knowingly, unknowingly, towards my business, I would have sold out 10 buses, second-hand buses, only 10 buses. Future also, I may not do, that data set itself indicates in the entire services of more than 10 or 15 years of my business, I would have been sold out only 10 buses. Most of the time I'll be dealing with only cars. Then what that signifies? There is no use of treating that bus. Anyway, my business is also not going to be with that kind of dealing in near future also. So that one analogy I'm trying to tell. So what I can do, that 10 bus detail, I need to throw it out. If I retain that, telling that it's all my past history, I want to include, I don't want to lose my past history and want to retain all those data, then really it will not be meaningful. In my past history also, I sold out only 10 buses. In future, definitely it will be very minimal. That data, if sits along with the car data, that will create a lot of disturbances, that will create a lot of error, then the prediction would go much poor performance. So for that, we need to work on the workable data range. What exactly? It's very simple. Whichever has smallest quantity, that all need to be treated. Wait a minute. Quantity. That all need to be thrown out. In each and every variable, we need to throw them out. All the smallest quantity representations. For that, let us look at one first example. Year of registration we are having. Year of registration. We are trying to use dot value counts dot sort index. If you look at, this is the function. Start counting based on the available years. One person would have been sold with me at 1980 model, 1999 model, 1929 model, whatever, year of registration, whatever. That all it will count automatically. How many people have handed over their car in the year called 1999, something like that. So that all it will come, it will count and it will sort also. Based on the highest to smallest, it will start sorting it. Then that is going to be preserved in year-wise count. If you wish, tomorrow what you can do is just split this command, isolate it out, then put these two lines into different cell, execute both, you will come to know what is available. But I give you a warning, 50,000 records will start displaying you. You need to keep on scrolling, that itself it will take maybe 5 minutes to 10 minutes, you may fed up. That's the reason. I don't want to do this year-wise count, then only viewing. With this only viewing we need to do, then we need to take decision. This shows that after the year 2018, only 26 cars are with me, registration year. Before 1950, only 38 cars are there. So these two things are need to be thrown.
One question.
Yeah.
So you know, 2018 we have some cutoff and 1950 is a cutoff. But without having some prior knowledge about the data, is there any way we can directly look at the distribution and say, okay,
min-max, we can do min-max. That min-max we can keep calculating the occurrences, how many counts are there with associated with that min-max. Other method, this one way we are doing counting for all, each and every year we are trying to count the occurrences,
but that will be very tedious. Now instead, can we not use box plot or something like a scatter plot?
That is also coming. Both way I'm dealing with the same notebook. This is for the numerical exploratory. Okay. Subsequently, we are going for visual exploratory, sir.
Okay. One second. I'll just talk to Girish and Suma. Yeah. Suma, everything is okay for you? Any questions or any changes you want to do?
Hello.
Yeah.
As of now, it's fine, Kanan sir.
Okay. Grisha, yeah, right? Yeah, okay.
I think Suma would have gone to mute mode yesterday.
Hello?
Yeah.
Festival. Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, yes, Suma. Are you comfortable?
Yeah, it's actually so noisy. That's why I couldn't able to. Hello?
Yes, ma. Yes, I could hear you. Please continue, ma. Yeah,
okay.
Fine.
I think she does not want to cause a lot of noise. That's fine. I think
I said that there is a festival going on, it seems. So okay, she is putting in the mute mode. Yeah.
Okay. So carry on, madam. I will.
Yeah. I will proceed, sir.
Okay.
Now the same. That is one way we are working with year of registration. Now we are moving for the next variable, year of registration versus price. This is it's also a kind of exploratory analysis through visual plot, whereas this numerical plot at time visual, I can say it may be very glamorous, but you cannot infer exactly what it is doing. Interpretation would be much more difficult with visual, in my opinion. Perhaps maybe other people may feel with the comfortable, I'm not sure. But numerical, very crisp. It's telling that, yes, I have 26 records, which are all greater than this. I have 38 records, which are all less than this. Yes, done. The job is done. So that I will be preferring most of the time the numerical analysis, that in one shot, it gives me the complete explanation. That's it. Nothing more. Now let's come back to red plot. This is one type of plot. It's useful for histogram analysis, histogram plotting, SNS. Whereas in matplotlib, equivalent to red plot, we will be using different function. Which package we are using, we may need to be very cautious. In that package, each and every plot type is verbalized with different terminologies. Here we may call red plot, there it may be different. So sometimes when we go for competitive exams, no, they will be asking what is the equivalent name of the plotting functions in SNS as well in this is seaborn. SNS means seaborn and matplotlib. By the time this kind of questions would be helpful. Otherwise, no need to worry of that. If you don't take up any competitive exam, it's not required. So we are fixing X as a year of registration. This is what shows X year of registration. Then Y is a price depending upon the registration year, what is the price we are fixing? This our ultimate objective is Y variable dealing with this. We are trying to please each and every variable, helping to predict this one, this value. Every variable trying to help us to predict this price. That's it. Okay. Now, 2000, the data is very clumsy and it's available. Then 4000, look at this, something like year of registration, 10,000, only two data, 8,000 something this data. What I am going to do with this very smaller amount of data? Sitting this all data will create a lot of error. We need to throw or truncate. So that is called workable data range. How much I'm going to retain, which range I'm going to. See, when we do business, extremities will come. Sometimes even I Rolls-Royce car also may come into my own business, but how many Rolls-Royce will come is a question mark. One or two. Retaining that one or two, it will sit and disturb all other data. So I need to sensitize which is not at all recovered. Rare business happens. By the time the rare business, no need to go for automation. Whenever my business revenue or the processing is going more, if look at Amazon, which is the item going more, fashion item, then coming to that electronics item, people will not purchase the highest costlier 1 crore product, 50,000 product, 5 lakhs product. Quite often they don't purchase. So there we need to work more than that. That is called workable range. We may need to sensitize the importance of most frequently sold out item. How can I predict my future sales and how can I help them out or whatever? One Rolls-Royce car may come. Very worst kind of car may come to your business. One or two worst kind of car you may deal with. But that all no need to retain. That all need to be thrown out. What kind of car you or vehicle you are dealing most of the time? That is called workable data range. That's what we are exploring. So this, what is this year of registration? I don't know. But look at the plot. It shows very few. Whereas here it shows a lot of clumsy pattern. Then this could be my workable range. I may need to throw this zone because very few clearly it says. So minimizing or fixing that workable range, min-max range, what range, minimum value, what I need to keep, maximum value I need to keep in that particular variable helps a lot in better prediction. Okay, same we will be doing, same story, but for each and every variable we'll be working on. Now this is vital or much more important variable. This is called dependent variable price, or Y variable rather we can say. This is Y variable. Same story. How we are doing? We are using the data frame, which variable we want, dot value underscore counts. How many? That particular price, how many are there? Then we are sorting. If you display this again, isolate it out and display, you will be going mad. So 50,000 value will be displaying. So using instead of this other way, I can recommend min-max also we can look at. For that min-max count, we can look at. This we discussed in the yesterday's notebook also. How to find out FL type house, how many are available, FSH house, how many are available. We discussed so many house types, patterns, that based on that, how to use that notebook has coding. Using that, we can simply calculate. That's fine. Next. Distance plot, again we are using distance. There we use reg plot. Here we are using distance plot. Why reg plot, why distance plot? Here we used two variables. Look at carefully. We are using vice versa. Year of registration, price. So whenever you combine two variable, XY variable, you mandatorily need to go for reg plot. Here we are dealing with only the price, one single variable. So that we need to go for, this plot, box plot. That's it. This is one famous plot people used to call box plot, but there is no big charming or appreciation in it. This box plot, rather I can say, it's equivalent to describe function what we used. It's called 8 variable function. It will give us max, mean, it will give us median, and it will give us 70-50% quartile, something, some 4-5 variable you can look at back. So that is what given by box plot. Look at this, there is no box is formed. You will laugh at me. I'm telling that it is a box plot. There is no box is formed. You just surf your Google how box plot looks. It will be exactly like this. There will be a box, there will be a range, there will be a minimum and a maximum. This, if you call it as max, this boundary, then naturally it would become minimum. Then this box plot will give us very clearly median value. Median value. Then this is called 25% quartile. This is called 75% quartile. Something like that it will do. So this all interquartile range it will give. This one interquartile range, this other interquartile range. This is called, I think so, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variable summary or 5 summary report it will give. Box plot is used to handle or understand 5 summary report. None of us can appreciate there is the existence of box. See, box means it should be like that. Maybe smaller or bigger or median, maybe middle exactly, or min max value, whatever that it should resemble box. This is called box plot. The moment even a kid can understand what is mean by box, that's all. Somewhere it should exist with box, but there is no box at all. Then we need to be very careful. We need to fix the workable range. If it does not gives any box plot, definitely that is another caution for us. We need to verify the workable range. Based on this, again, we are trying to use summation of this price value less than something. This may be either in dollar or rupees, you know, 1,50,000 and the price 100 rupees. Imagine there are car people selling out with 100 rupees. Can you imagine that? That all may be some wrong data entry, or we don't know why that 100 rupees selling business had come into the picture. We need to throw them out. So this is called workable range. I need to fix the range. Now my working range is between greater than 100 to, what to say? Yeah, greater than 100 to greater than 1,50,000. This data only I need to retain. How I am getting this inference? That is another question. This inference, we need to look at this first one. This frame only helps me to understand this all information. But for scrolling purpose, I'm not using it. That's why I'm telling, when you are working alone, isolate this code, this line, put it in one cell, understand what is the value it starts displaying, start inferring why I'm using this, or you can come and argue why not this range. Yes, fine, fantastic. But you need to do this one. Yeah, let's move to, this is what we are trying to do. Each and every variable we are exploring, we are understanding for the workable range. There are people without workable range, directly they jump to the concept called normality or normal conversion, normal distribution they will apply. This won't work out. At time, we need to be very careful before even applying normal distribution. We need to treat the data with workable range. Then the beauty of prediction, you will appreciate a lot. So this is mandatory. Maybe due to ritual or we don't know, people will directly go for normal distribution. This we need to do first. This must be our second step. Yeah, next we go to power PS, that power of the vehicle. At time, I don't know few terminologies, what exactly. Those who know about vehicle can articulate a lot. But here also, we are coming to science now. There is no art we are doing with this. Science says what? Count the value, find out the minimal existence of the data, throw them out. That's it. That is science. Science is fixed. Science cannot be changed by anyone. So now what we are doing, we are trying to describe, and again we are going for reg plot. Why we are reg plot? Power PS versus price we are trying to fix. Now this reg plot also very clumsy structure, nothing it gives. See, most of the data are dumped towards that 0.0. Very few data occurrences comes towards this one. This sparse comes out. Other than that, there is no spot. It's a very flat line. So what we are trying to do, again using power PS, we are fixing the workable range. Greater than 500, 115, less than 10, these many records available. We need to again clean it. So using these all explorative, we are trying to understand only the workable range. We haven't done any action on our data yet now. Simply, we are trying to understand how we are making a friend with anyone. We try to gather information. We will try understanding the person. It is same like we are doing. We are not taking any action. Just we are gathering information about the data set, who is a new person into our life. So we are trying to understand the data set. That's it. Now only we are trying the working range of data. This working range of data, so far now what we discussed, everything we are applying here in a single line. Cars equal to cars of year of registration. First we started with year of registration, then we had gone to the price, then we had come to the end, power PS. All the working range of data we are putting together. We are commanding a Python or whatever, we are going to collect this kind of data. It starts working as a servant. So it starts looking at this kind of data within this range, all the given specified. See, and we are using, we need to be careful. All put together, we are throwing out. Not we are throwing out based on only the registration either or price or power PS. All combinations, we are going to throw it out. So that all putting this all together combination, all the records are pulled to the variable cars. Now what we are trying to do, that's fine. From this point onwards, that we are keeping it. We haven't taken any decision. We are keeping it in cars. Let us see a little bit later. Next, what we are trying to do, feature engineering. Again, I emphasize feature engineering is an art. It's not a science. We need to understand each and every variable. We need to apply our thought process. We need to take decision. So this month of registration, we are trying to divide by 12. We are going to do moderations for month of registration, combining year of registration and month of registration instead of two different fields. We are trying to convert it into single field. Then month of registration need to be promoted to year, something like that. So we need to divide by 12. Next, we are trying to fix the workable range, or we are converting to age of the car. Finally, what we are doing, month of registration gives one information, year of registration gives one information. Based on this, I am trying to find age of the car. So age of the car, how we need to find out? The current year minus all the past history, past story, year of registration, month of registration, addition, then division, this all we are doing. Then 2018 minus this all calculations we are subtracting. We are taking a round function describing. Now description, it's equivalent to box plot. Description always will give me 449. Yeah, 9 summary report. Count value, how many records are of this kind, whatever. Then mean, standard deviation, minimum 25% interquartile range, 50%, 75% max. Now we are coming for dropping certain columns. Dropping year of registration, month of registration. Why we need to drop? These two people helped us to find out the age. Now age is calculated. No need of retaining these persons. We need to throw them out. Otherwise, redundant information will be retained. These two indirectly are feature engineering we did to calculate age. Somehow we got the age of the car. That is what exactly or precisely required for the prediction than even year of registration, month of registration. See, if I keep on telling you for the normal conversation, just imagine what I'm talking. I'm trying to sell my car with you. If I'm telling you a lot of story, this is the month I registered, December month, 2005, I went to that fellow, I met them, then registration, if a year of registration, these all stories, if I try to tell you what you can infer, then what is a price you can fix for my car, will you ready to buy or not, these are all the story business I'm talking. Instant, straight to the point, I'm telling 4.5 years old my car, that's it. Are you ready to purchase my car or not? My car is 5.5 years old. So I used more than 6 years. Approximately, I would have used 6 years. If I talk like this, how much meaningful it is? Sharply, you will take decision instead of telling these all kind of stories. So that's what we are doing here. How human does the job, the same thought process we are applying on the data. Year of registration, month of registration, that all will not help in fixing the price of the car. That's what we have converted. We are trying to convert. Once the conversion is done, these two people helped us to calculate age. Let it be. we are thankful to this flow, even then we need to throw them out. Now let's go for next. We are going for almost normal distribution or understanding age of the car. Age of the car based on the age, the present calculation, just now we calculated age, we are trying to plot. This plot is exactly called normal distribution. If you look at it's a fantastic curve. It's almost resembles a bell shape or Gaussian shape, whatever. But look at this trailing. There is a tail. This tail we should not carry. This all again unwanted data. Very minimal, slowly it is leading to this kind of thing. Somehow need to be treated. Now we are calculating age. Immediately we are trying to understand the new arrival. This is a new guest of our data set. So we need to understand this new guest also. Now go back to box plot. Yeah, see how fantastic. Now only we are seeing box plot. This is called box median, min max value. See, after min and max, so much data, 6 years. What is the relationship? This tail and this, both are friend of each other. This fellow, these two fellows, there is no use. It's a dragging. It is becoming skewed. That skewness should not be there. We need to throw or we need to convert, normalize, do whatever. These are all workable range. Either we can interpret with box plot also, or we can interpret with the normal curve also. Next, we are trying to do disk plot. This also normality check. There is no direct word normality will be there. We may need to use either histogram if we use matplotlib, or we need to use disk plot in the seaborn. Here also need to be treated a lot. See, a long tail sits here. Skew is happening. Although it resembles normal, there is a tail. This tail need to be treated. This all just understanding, we haven't not started it. Next, what we are doing, box plot for the price. This we did, I think, repetition, I think so. So here, attempt copy paste, the code will happen, then repetition would be there. Now, similarly, we are trying to understand normal distribution of the power S. Power S is also fantastic. Little bit of normal distribution or normality is existing. However, there is a tail. This tail need to be dealt. Again, SNS box plot cost the same only coming, I think so. Power is box plot. Okay, fine. Next, red plot. Age versus price. The newly entered guest of the data is age. Now we are trying to understand interrelationship. So interrelationship, what and all we can understand. Look at this scatter, fit, red, false, data equal to cars. See, this is extremity, outlier. Only one car of, look at the beauty, 0 years used, selling price is 40, something, 1,40,000, whatever. 60 to 80 years or months, maybe this is month only, 60 to 70. What, although highest number of months the person is using the car, the sale price is very peak. Never such kind of thing will come. Maybe that may be the costlier car or the engine model, maybe the rare model, something like that. So these are all outlier. Now this red plot helps us to find out the outlier. Yesterday we dealt with the data set, what is outlier. There are 4 different variables we discussed yesterday. The same only we are trying to do here. Again, red plot. Power PS versus price. So here also there are few extremities, one something like that. We are just observing all those things. Next, variable seller, commercial seller, private seller. What we are trying to do is we are trying to count based on the seller type. Only 2 types of sellers available in the data set, either commercial or private. So we are trying to count it then we are going for cross tabulation. I said already very beginning, what is cross tabulation? Boys and girls in a class, so we can do cross tabulation. There are two category of students available. Then I can do what way cross tabulation is. I can group them up failures. I can group them up pass candidate, or I can group them meritorious or extraordinary. So I need to give you a count. How many boys in a class failed in a subject? Maybe 10 boys, maybe 20 girls, then pass. This is called cross tabulation. Two different parameters we are combining together and taking judgment or taking a count on it. So 25, I'm just filling randomly. It must match with the number of students. Definitely they will fit into any one category only. If number of students in a class, perhaps I have used the maximum count 100, then supposed to fix 150 or something like that. Then excellent. Here excellent 5, girls maybe 2, something like that I'm fixing. Then what would happen? This is called cross tabulation. Then this signifies which category of students are more in with us, which category of students are very less with us. Some kind of analysis or exploration inferences we can take out with the support of cross tabulation. That's what we are trying to do here. Count commercial, how many are there? Private, how many are there? Only one person here available based on the count. So now we are understanding about seller also. Now let us move to count plot. Private members are more. Then I think so. Yeah, normalize equal to true. Then this is called probability. Probability of occurrence we are trying to do. Zero probability, nothing, no. One is commercial. One, highest probability. Probability always will work between the range 0 to 1. Look at the beauty of this. There is no person with me with a commercial mode. All are into private. Probability is extreme 1. See, look at the graph also. Commercial, no person is sitting. Private, all are sitting in with the data set is sitting to the private. Next, offer type. Offer type values, I don't know. Okay, let us see. Offer type, only one band is available. No other category, no other bands are available. Just we are observing. Everything we are exploring, we are understanding each and every columns and parameters of the data set. Next, again, probability we are finding out. A-B test. I said na, something like a test condition of the vehicle. So that A-B test we are doing. Controlled category 0.48, test category 0.51, equal probability. 51 and 48%, 51%, there is no big difference. Person who is getting 48 marks, person who is getting 51 marks cannot be ill-treated each other. So it's a kind of nearby value. We can retain. Both can equally play a role. Next, the same we are trying to do with the exploratory. What this entire book I'm trying to attempt is, most of the exploration or functionalities I'm trying to give you both the numerical way of exploration and the graphical way of exploration. That is the aim I'm trying to do. That's why this notebook book specially I have brought. There are people mostly tend to use graphical, but when you are being a data scientist, when you want to do or any decision making or any kind of advanced techniques to be applied, then visual plot will not help us at all, only the numerical plot. But the moment you are going for presentation, you are trying to teach or you are trying to impress your attendees, then naturally visual plot only will be helpful. So that you can talk a lot of stories. So they will also interpret easily. So it's depending upon the situation and the context. On the field work, you need to work with numerical. For social presentations, you may need to go with visuals. Again, box plot, A-B test versus price we are doing. So here, lot of data sits beyond that boundary, box boundary. Here also, lot of data sits beyond the boundary, but it is minimal. We have 50,000 records. Out of that, mostly sits here. Very few or going out of the box. Whenever any plot comes beyond the box, box already said there will be a line here boundary line. Middle, we will get a box. Any point we could see beyond that boundary lines, that all or need to be handled separately, need to be treated. Outliers we can say perhaps sometime. Now let us move to vehicle type. Again, vehicle type, we are finding out the probability. Bus, cabrio, something. These are all the name of the vehicle available, SUV. So which is the vehicle I'm dealing very, very minimal? SUV, this is the vehicle I'm dealing very minimal. Now, if you wish, you can retain that or you can throw it out. Because that business I'm not doing much at all. Most of the time I'm dealing with, these are all the vehicle type. So the next minimal is cabrio. The next minimal is, this coupe, something like that. Very minimal others, 0.008. It's not at all required for us to retain if at all we want to fix the workable range. So this is another way of looking at the workable range. So using probability, normalized equal to true if we set, and if we use cross tabulation, this I included the exact coding, the same coding in the PPT. Now the PPT which I shared, maybe day 4 PPT, something like that. If you look at that, it will be available. Next, count plot. So what we are looking at in the probability value, same we are looking at through bar graph in terms of count. Both will be same. Look at others will be very minimal. Where is others? Others I couldn't even make out at all. Look at, that is the beauty. That visual plot, how it falsifies or fools us. Others is a category not at all able to sensitize. That is very low. See, 0.008. That is why numerical is a safer side for us. Then we may not even notice we have a category called others when we look at the visual plot. So choice is yours. That's it. Now let's go back to box plot, vehicle type versus price. So again, vehicle versus type versus price. So everywhere there is a boundary. Beyond that, the prices goes higher. These all outlier, extreme value that vehicle would have been sold out. Look at whatever the bus I dealt in my business, one bus is extraordinary, highest price I sold out. So this one, these kind of business normally will happen very rarely. So no need to retain these data. These all will sit and create a lot of error in the prediction. So need to be dealt and thrown out. Next, we are looking at model. These are all the model type. So many models are there. If we fix the model, it will become lesser when you compare to name of the vehicle. Maruti, Suzuki, that all name, they will, sometime most of the vehicle, they will retain the same engine model. They modify other features, seating arrangement or elevation of the vehicle, whatever they change it. The engine model would be the same with the same vendors or Ford. Let us take Ford. Whatever the manufacturing car they are trying to do, couple of vehicle will have same engine model. The other facilities and luxury of the car, they will change. That's it. Now, instead of retaining the name of the vehicle, we are retaining model of the vehicle. Again, we are trying to find out the probability. So this zero probability, 159 model, nothing is available. When I compare with all other my data set, it's very, very negligible. That signifies that I would have sold only one car, 159, 200 only one car. So that one car business, what it's going to make, sir? Surprisingly, some peculiar cases will come into our business, 90, 900. So these all no need to be retained and need to be treated or thrown out. Then again, we are plotting. See how much variations. If you look at this end, very, very negligible. We can't even make out where the plot is. Even if you put a macroscopic lens also, we can't make out. So these all would be one count, zero count, five count. Our data set is very huge. 50,000 data we are having. Out of that 50,000 data, 50 is very, very negligible. If I have 50, very, very smallest, tiny particle. That's what we couldn't make out in the plot.